Touch of gloves. We are underway. Esquibel coming forward hard. Roscoe with a combination. Esquibel very aggressive here. You got to expect that from Jodie.
She is. You know, when she made the jump to strawweight, I was worried because she's quite short for this division. But, man, she has not lost any of her muscularity. Now it's going to be a fight for who has dominance on the cage, who has better position on the cage. Alexa's done some, beautiful knees from the clinch there.
Esquibel now trying to get a takedown. Grasso stuffs it. Nicely done by the former strawweight number one contender. Beautiful elbow there by Grasso. Esquibel staying tough here, trying to keep the pressure on.
Sorry, there was a lady behind us coaching from the crowd. Alexa Grasso can generate so much power from such a little frame and against the cage, which is really hard to do. She's very crisp, very on point tonight.
Esquibel looping left hand comes in, answered by a left hand of Grasso's. Now Esquibel shooting in far from the outside.
Yeah, you can see, she definitely wants that takedown. That was
nicely done by Grasso.
Nice turnover from Grasso and strikes on the way up.
Beautifully done there by Alexa Grasso.
Pushing
couple punches off the break.
Straight off the forehead to give her range. Grasso throw.
Beautiful kick to the body there. Esquibel might be hurt. She's trying to get a takedown again.
Yeah, that was.
Nicely done again by Grasso. Sorry, Julie.
No. That was a beautiful shot. Like, that was right on the liver. Elbows to the head. Right there. Grasso
Esquibel
is so vicious.
Esquibel working hard on this takedown. Now Grasso flirting with controlling the head of Esquibel. Now Jodie eating a lot of hard elbows here. Alexa Grasso.
Yeah, Jodie needs to give up that double leg attempt to go straight to a single leg on Grasso's left leg, or she's in some serious trouble here.
Sternly example here early of why Alexa Grasso has everyone excited at 115 pounds. Nice kick to the head of Esquibel by Grasso. Now Esquibel trying to get a takedown. Big knee upcoming there by Esquibel landed, but Grasso still game. Nice elbow standing. Hard to keep up with the strawweight action.
I know. You caught one side and the other one does something. Nice knee from Esquibel. Grasso, again, she can just generate so much power from her back to the cage. I wish I'd have learned how to do that. Nice elbow, and Esquibel continues to push forward.
Another kick there. That one caught, though, by Esquibel. Now back inside the clinch. Final 10 seconds here this round.
And I think it's very smart of Esquibel when she grabs a kick to just try and kick the other leg out or trip the other leg out. I know that sounds simplistic, but honestly, the level is high. Nicely done. Jodie takes her down off of a kick, but then allows her to get back up.
A right hand landed on the way down by Esquibel, but again, Grasso back to her feet. Now again at space. Over the halfway point of this bout. Again, our main event, 3 5-minute rounds tonight in the strawweight division. TJ DeSantis, Julie Kedzie, Scottish Rite, Kansas City, Missouri, Invicta FC 18.
The shots are so fast. They're just kind of like half an inch away of where they need to be.
And when Esquibel comes forward, Grasso isn't backing straight up, always moving, circling.
Generally to her right, because that's where she can generate more power. She'll step her left leg a little bit on the outside and then shift over to hit that right hand. She's doing an excellent job of keeping that jab, using it to keep Esquibel at range. It's what you need to do with a shorter fighter. You just need to keep punching them. Not that simplistic, guys, but I mean with that jab, you just need to keep it in their face, make it seem like they can't get in. Now Jodie is, that's the third time she's grabbed the kick to get an attack. It's a good strategy.
Esquibel rocked by a nice left and right.
And she's got a hold of that leg, but unless she gets it to the ground, she's going to continue to be hit.
Blood flowing out of the nose of Jodie Esquibel. Final 10 seconds here of round number 2. Nice right hand on the break by Esquibel. Jodie has yet to ever stop coming forward, and for her trouble, she's got a busted up nose. But I like that. If Jodie Esquibel is going to win, she can't afford to take a step back.
No, not at all. She's got to pull a Simona here, like we saw earlier. She's got to just keep going and going. Go for that finish. Keep putting those combinations together, never slowing down.
When you think about a fight with maybe Ashley Cummins down the road
for.
Oh, they fought. That's right. Yeah, no, you're right.
Yeah, she got her. Yeah, no, that was Alexa Grasso's.
Oh, hard right hand by Grasso. Esquibel backpedaling for the first time. Grasso bunching up some punches.
Now, Jodie's job here is to not let there be any space, because the space is where Grasso is going to keep attacking. She smells blood. She's like a shark.
It's all over her left hand. Grasso moving forward. Esquibel not getting away. Deep kick tries to make space for Alexa. Or for Esquibel, rather.
Yeah.
Mike England calls a halt to this for a brief moment. We're going to check the nose of Jodie Esquibel. Jodie Esquibel still game. Two-punch combination for Esquibel. Hard to the body with a right hand and a kick for good measure. Esquibel getting aggressive.
Yeah.
And a nice right hand.
That's kind of amazing after almost having the fight stop that Esquibel's still going to keep coming forward. And again.
Oh, beautiful elbow there by Grasso.
Oh, Grasso is relentless. She's working that nose, and now she's getting her shots in. She wants this fight to end. She does not want to go to a decision. She wants to be definitive in her quest for a title shot.
Touch over 90 seconds remain here in the third and final round.
You can't teach that kind of heart. Just like, I don't think, you know, some of the stuff coming from Alexa is just so sharp. That kind of timing, you can teach timing, but oh my goodness.
Esquibel shot deep on that single leg, but look at Alexa Grasso. Her wrestling has been really good.
Oh, it's been great. She's been defensively beautiful, still attacking while she's defending takedowns. Alexa Grasso is firmly in control of this fight, and she's really making a statement tonight.
Now Grasso going for a takedown.
Jodie trying to reverse. Grasso relentless on that, staying on her. Final. Driving her head into Esquibel's chin.
Final 20 seconds here. Grasso moves back to space. Invites Esquibel back to the center. Jodie still game, but battered and bloodied. And I think we're going to find out ultimately beaten here in Kansas City.
For your winner by unanimous decision and still undefeated, Alexa Grasso!